हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल प्लांट पैथोलॉजी पाठशाला। आई एम झुमिश्री मेहर, पीएचडी स्कॉलर फ्रॉम बनारस हिंदू यूनिवर्सिटी। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द मॉडल्स फॉर जीन इंटरेक्शन, दैट इज द थ्री मॉडल्स। ओके, जीन फॉर जीन मॉडल, गार्ड मॉडल एंड डिकॉय मॉडल। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट पैटर्न ट्रिगर्ड इम्यूनिटी, दैट इज इंड्यूस्ड बाय PRR और पैटर्न रिकॉग्निशन रिसेप्टर्स बाय परसीविंग द PAMs और पैथोजन एसोसिएटेड मॉलिकुलर पैटर्न्स, ओके, व्हिच इंड्यूसेस द बैसल रेजिस्टेंस और PTI, दैट इज पैटर्न ट्रिगर्ड इम्यूनिटी। वेयर एज द इफेक्टर दैट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय पैथोजन व्हिच ब्रेक दिस बैसल रेजिस्टेंस एंड इन टर्न द प्लांट ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस आर जीन्स और रेजिस्टेंस जीन्स टू कम्बैट दिस इफेक्टर मॉलिक्यूल एंड इंड्यूसेस द ETI और इफेक्टर ट्रिगर इम्यूनिटी, दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज आर जीन मेडिएटेड रेजिस्टेंस। सो इन प्लांट टू टाइप ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इज सीन, वन इज बैसल रेजिस्टेंस दैट इज PTI एंड अनदर इज आर जीन मेडिएटेड रेजिस्टेंस और ETI। नाउ वी गॉट दैट ड्यू टू जीन इंटरेक्शन और इंटरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोटीन प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय दिस जीन रिजल्ट इन रेजिस्टेंस और ससेप्टिबिलिटी। So we will discuss now how this gene interaction, that is between the effector and R gene, occurs. Okay. First one is how R gene interacts with the effectors. So three models are there by which R gene interacts with effector molecules. First one is gene for gene model. This is also known as floor hypothesis. Second one is guard model. Third one is decoy model. We will discuss all this model one by one in the next slide. First one is gene for gene model or gene for gene concept, or it is also known as Floor hypothesis. This is given by H.S. Floor in 1955. He is the first plant pathologist who analyzed the plant pathogen interaction at genetic level while working in linseed rust fungi, that is Melamopsora lini. So according to this hypothesis, for each gene conditioning rust disease in host, there is a specific gene conditioning the pathogenicity in the parasite. That is, for R gene in plant, there is a corresponding AVR gene is there in the pathogen for resistance, whereas for susceptibility there is a corresponding virulence gene is there in the pathogen. So in this table, the capital R means there is a functional resistance gene present in the plant, whereas small or recessive R means functional resistance gene is not present in the plant. Then the AVR, capital or dominant one, means pathogen is having a avirulence gene, whereas small or recessive AVR means pathogen is having a virulence gene, or pathogen is virulent, whereas in this case pathogen is avirulent. So the result of gene interaction, we got that in only in one cases incompatible reaction is occurring and plant is become resistant, whereas in the rest three cases compatible reaction is occurring and plant is become susceptible or disease is developing. So for resistance, a functional dominant R gene must be there in plant, whereas a dominant AVR gene or avirulence gene must be there in pathogen. Only in this condition the plant will become resistant, whereas in rest three cases plant will become susceptible one. So let's consider this blue one as pathogen effector. So two cases may be there. First one is a functional R gene may be present in the plant, or a functional R gene may be absent in the plant. So if a R gene is present in the plant, it will perceive the pathogen effector and it will activate the immune system. So the plant become resistant and disease will not develop. Whereas when the functional R gene is absent in plant, then the pathogen effector will be not recognized and it will trigger susceptibility, and it will trigger also the effector triggered susceptibility, okay, and plant will become diseased. So now let's discuss the floor hypothesis at biochemical level. Let's consider these two as two pathogen with two genetic background. One is having capital A1 or dominant A virulence gene, whereas in another case, small A1 means A virulence is in recessive condition. So this capital A1 condition will produce specific elicitors or effectors that can be recognized by resistance gene present in plant, and that pathogen will call as A virulent pathogen, whereas the small A1 or recessive one is not produced any type of specific elicitor or effectors that can be recognized by a R gene. That pathogen will called as virulent pathogen. So virulence is a relative term, means every pathogen is having the capacity to cause disease, but it depends on plant genetic condition whether it allows the pathogen to cause disease or not. On that basis, if a pathogen is having effectors or it producing effectors which can be recognized by a plant R gene, then we call it as a virulent one. Whereas if pathogen is not producing any specific effectors or elicitor which can be recognized by a R gene present in plant, that condition we call it as virulent one. Okay, so pathogen is same, only difference is in the production of effector molecules. In plants, two condition is there. One is it is having resistance gene or receptor to recognize effector molecule, that is capital R1 condition. Whereas in case of small R1 condition, the plant is lacking the receptor or R gene. Similarly, in pathogen, capital R1 means A virulent, that is producing effector that can be recognized by R gene, whereas small A1 means virulent one, that is not producing effector that can be recognized by R gene. So by plant and pathogen interaction, we can have four situation, okay? This fourth situation, that is capital A1 R1, that is small A1 capital R1, then capital R1 small R1, then small A1 capital small R1. In the first case, that is capital A1 capital R1, both the receptor and the elicitor or the effector both are present, that is the R gene present in plant and a effector molecules is also produced by a pathogen which can be recognized by the R gene present in the plant. So R gene will then perceive the effector and it will trigger the effector triggered immunity in plant, that is the ETI will be triggered in plant and plant become resistant. Whereas in second case, that is small A1 and capital R1, means receptor or R gene is there, but the pathogen is virulent one, means it is not producing specific effector that can be recognized by a plant. That is, here you can see the receptor is there, but the production of elicitor is not there, means plant fails to recognize the pathogen and disease will develop. Then in the third case, that is capital A1 small R1, means the pathogen is a virulent one, means it is producing specific elicitor or effector molecules, but the plant is lacking the R gene or the receptor. So again, plant fails to perceive or recognize the pathogen, and the effector molecule that is produced by the A virulent pathogen will trigger the effector trigger susceptibility or ETS, and plant will become diseased. In the fourth case, that is small A1 and R1, it lacks both the receptor and effector molecules. So the plant fails to recognize the pathogen and again disease will develop. So only in first case, that is capital A1 and capital R1, plant will become resistant one. Now I think you are clear about flour hypothesis. This is the gene for gene hypothesis. But actually this gene are not interacting. Actual interaction occurs between the gene product, that is the protein. So proteins are this gene product which is actually interacting to induce either disease or resistance. So the hypothesis for protein and protein interaction is given by Van der Planck. So now you are clear that gene for gene concept is given by Plohr, whereas protein for protein concept is given by Van der Planck. So this is the end of today's video. In the next video, we will discuss the guard model and decoy model. So if you like this video, please comment and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to click the bell icon to get more and more notification from my channel, Plant Pathology Paathshala. Thank you.